You listened to the announcement yesterday, and you weren't particularly wowed. Where's Apple service falling short?
Well, it just seems to me Apple Music, as they laid it out yesterday, just doesn't really have anything in the way of convincing differentiators. And if you look at what they think, Apple thinks makes Apple Music special, you have Beats One, a radio station, an internet radio station that is dedicated to live programming 24/7, which is great. It's a good idea. The thing is, if that was an idea that would move the needle, SiriusXM would be one of the most successful companies in history, because that's what they're all about. So I don't think that's going to do much for them. Then there's the Connect feature, which is essentially artists' bonus content, the kind of things you'd sort of get in CD liner notes or on a bonus DVD, getting exclusive access to that. That is okay, but it's really only something super fans kind of get into. And I really didn't see much of a case on why these artists wouldn't just put this extra content on YouTube or some other service and just cut out the middleman.
Right, and Twitter, which they're all using. You know, Pete, one of the big questions here, I think, for this entire genre is whether people really want to pay subscription for music. A lot of these other services have the freemium model. They've converted some to subscription, but not all. People have been reluctant. Apple is doing a 3-month trial, but then it's going to be subscription. Do we know whether people want that?
Yeah, well, they will have a free offering. Now, let's be clear. They'll still keep iTunes Radio, although I believe that name is going away. So the free version of Apple Music will let you stream radio. You just won't get it on demand. But you're right. I mean, streaming music, it hasn't really been super convincing to a lot of people to spend $10 a month, even if it is all you can eat, even if you do get the offline listening as Apple Music and other services offer, it's just not worth it to people. I think a lot of people will take the radio and that's enough for them. To pay $9.99, I mean, I think back to myself on how much money I've actually spent on individual tracks over the past few years, and it's nowhere near that much on a monthly basis.